Hi, it's Loan from Google Tech, and it's been a while from the last time we talked about using Blink app to control self-promoter. Last time I used the Raspberry Pi 2 to control a self-promoter, but these days it's really hard to find Raspberry Pi at a standalone computer. In the opposite, you can very easy to find the Raspberry Pi Pico Clio. It's like $8-$10. And you can connect it to Blink app too. So I'm gonna make a review video to show you how to control servo motor with this new microcontroller. Let's talk about the hardware. I use the same servo motor that I used before. This is very typical. You can see it has three wires. This is the one. Orange, red, and brown. The brown one should be connected to the zero, ground. The red one should be connected to the 5 volt supply. Some people connect it to 3.3 volt here of the Raspberry Pico W, but it won't be enough for it to work. And the last wire is the orange one, is the PWM that you can connect to any GPIO pin of the Raspberry Pi Pico W. Here I use the GPIO 15. So that's all about the hardware connection. Let's have a look at how this servo motor work. I just want to sum up so for people that don't never have experience with this one. It has a PWM period of 20 milliseconds, and the duty cycle can be aside from 1 to 2 milliseconds. For one, it's gonna be go to maximum one side, let's say minimum side of it, and when it gets to 1.5 millisecond, it's gonna be in the middle, and when it gets to 2 milliseconds, it's gonna go to the other side. I call it the right side. So yeah, this is about the hardware, and now let's talk about the Blink app. Blink, they got updated to the new, like the Blink Internet of Thing, but the app you can download it from the Google Play, and here's my app already open, and my device is here, which I use for the demo, but now we can start to do all over again. So you can go to here and we can add a new device. Okay, which star device it have it, so it's faster. So let's go here. We're gonna use Raspberry Pi, and connection is Wi-Fi. So yeah, then we go with continue. So you see you have a quick start device here. I wanna edit some information. With the name here, I can put, let's say here is the Pico. Pico W. Okay, just to see different from the project I already have there. And then when you click on done, okay. Yes, all the information is correct in the timelines. Okay, so now let's close it and go to here. Depend on the WISTA template you have there. In my case, I re-edited it with that template, so I have a button here. But if you have any different, don't worry, you can click on this and add the button from here anyway. Then when you click on the button, you can change the kind of button you want. Here we use the I choose the switch one so that we have the control level of 0 or 1. Okay, so that's all you need to do for this project. Then they said that go to your computer, check your email to see they're gonna tell you how to use this kind of thing, but you can go straight to your Blink console right now. Okay, you see I have two device here. This is Pico W that I just created, so we can just click onto this. We saw the button here because it is the type of switch control. Remember that part I'm gonna talk about the yeah, I'm gonna show you right here. This part that we only choose it to switch control with the integer 0 and 1. Okay, so that's the one. And when you go to, sorry, metadata. Oh, sorry, device info. You're gonna see this is the most important thing that we need from the app. You see the Blink Alton token. You need that to put on your Python code. so that you can control it using your cell phone. So this, you need to copy this code and then put it to your Python. Now let's come have a look at our Python code here. Let me open back the phone and the thing for you to see. So okay. Now let's have a look at our code. And first of all, you will need to import the blinklib app library, because that is how you can connect to the Blink Internet of Things. Then you need the machine library. This is for you to work with the Raspberry Pi Pico, Pico W. So for the PWM pin, first of all, you will choose, you set the pin connection is number 15. Remember, we don't really say that we use the GPL 15. You can choose another pin, it doesn't matter. Just put the correct number here. And with this motor, because of data, she said that it's 20 milliseconds and 50 hertz. So you can put here PWM.frequent is 50. It means 20 milliseconds of the PWM period. Then there will be one whole section just to connect this one to the internet. You will need your network name and the password. And the Blink Alton, you need your Blink Alton token here. You should put it here. Then there's a couple pieces of code to handle the connection. So we don't touch that. Now, what is the most important is how to connect it to Blink, how to manage the event when a button it push or not. Okay, let me put it, turn it off this one. Okay. Okay, did Pico W. So yeah, here. When the button here is V0, so we have a Blink on V0 here, just to handle when the button boost. I put a very simple code, which is set the duty cycle to 1 millimeter when it go to the left, then go to the middle, then it go to the right, and then come back to the middle. And when the button will be up, we're gonna just stop the PWM for the servo motor. And then we need a while loop to run the Blink here. So now let's set this to run. I will need to copy the code to the new authentication code to put here for it to run, okay? So now when I re-put my Wi-Fi passwords and username and also token, you can just run it here. You see, it's gonna start with the Blink pictures here. Then it said it's connected. Now let's go have a look at our thing here, because here it's already online. You hear? Okay. So let me check if it's work here. Left, middle, right, left. No, so middle again. So you see, left, middle, right, middle. So when I turn it up, nothing gonna happen. Then I can restart again. See, that's how cycle is. We can also try with my phone. This is the phone in here, but it's gonna be the same with your phone. So let me put my phone. Okay, you can see here, my phone here. Okay, this is on, turn it to up. Okay, you see how it updated between this phone and the one on the screen. So on, left, middle, right, middle. This is off, left, middle, right, middle. So yeah, let's turn it up. So this is how you can control a servo motor using the Raspberry Pi microcontroller with Wi-Fi. I hope this is useful for your project. And if you like it, please subscribe to my channel so we can see in the next one. Happy making!